You tell me that Brian knows about the narcotic, right?
Yeah, Brian knows about Jesus. Brian, I guess they're coming on now. I think they're going to call in. Do they call? Oh, they're going to call.
We're just watching you now through Ustream. We've muted it so that it should work out a whole lot better. How are you? You look gorgeous in your hat. Love you.
Yeah, it's the roots, you know. Oh, I just want to. My shirt. I have something. I have something else on her. Yeah, but I can back into my jacket.
Is that your Jesus spleen?
Yeah.
Doll room.
My Jesus thing shirt, that's my pajamas.
Lovely, love it, love it, love it. Now, Yara's over here, I'll have him say hello. He's watching and recording everything.
Okay.
Hello, how are you?
I love you.
Yeah, you too.
I'm so funny.
I like you too.
You've been fighting the good fight, babe. We watch everything that you do.
I try to come hard sometimes. And sometimes it's a tough time and it seems like it's hard to explain everything, you know? I want to tell the audience right now.
I'll just bring correction to the vinegar bit that I was trying to post and it's not letting me post it. Everything is to fulfill prophecy and the Hindi Vedas are actually older than the Scroll of Isaiah. It's about 800 or 2,000 year difference actually. And the Hindu Vedas prophesied Jesus Christ on the cross, his crucifixion. Before that, the ministry that he had, even identified the vinegar that he would sup on. And then of course it's all laid out in the Isaiah scroll. So everything is to fulfill prophecy. And he did die. I know there's a lot of speculation, especially coming through the Gnostic and the Essene community and those kinds of writings, because the Essenes were healers, that is true. And Jesus, of course, was an Essene. He was king of the tribe of Judah, and it was the Jews who were the Pharisees from Babylon already controlling the temple that crucified him. But it was all part of the DVD. It's all to fulfill prophecy, and all so that he could get here now. And also the Shroud of Turin, everybody's misinterpreted the Shroud of Turin, you're exactly right, it was, he is the source of the light emanating from his body, we call it nuclear, whatever you like, but it burned the image of the soul of the Father, of course, that was always in Yeshua, Jesus, and the soul. Now, the blood ran down, because they got it through the heart, and it ran down the left side and is, at the time it was happening, there was an earthquake and the blood ran in through the earth, down underneath the cross where Jeremiah's grotto had the Ark of the Covenant hidden 600 years before. That blood is there today and it was found by Ron White in 1982 on January the 6th at 2 p.m. in the afternoon. He took the blood, he scraped it off with the top of a Coke can, took it to the laboratory in Jerusalem to be analysed, and they found that the blood was human blood. It had just 24 chromosomes, all humans have 46 chromosomes. There were 23 chromosomes from the Mother Mary and just one Y chromosome. That's why he is the Alpha and the Omega, the Alpha male, the only begotten from the Father. Now, what the instrument of Joseph ben Jacob Israel, because it is all about genetics, he was used as the vessel. He did go in unto Mary, the Catholic Church, a couple of hundred years later, in order to fantasize everything and turn it into a fantasy production, said it was there was no father involved. Well, Gabriel actually appeared to Joseph before Mary and told, get up and go in unto Mary, your espoused wife, because from your loins the seed will come that will bring forth the Son of God. He was known to
have the more we use the internet, the more our current copper network is struggling to keep up. After all, it was originally designed for phones, not today's internet.
I really want you to hear those ads.
The original broadband network is a network that can deliver our needs now and into the future.
So Joseph ben Jacob Israel, who was the king of Judah, he was used as the vessel to shoot the Y chromosome only. That's the miraculous part. But the seed came from his loins because it is all about the root of Jesse and the genetic bloodline, actually back to Jesse, who was the father of David. So, and of course it had to, the way, the bloodline had to be perpetuated, and that's what it's all about. Just as the Illuminati and all of the opposition, the enemy to mankind, are so intent on bloodlines, they know that the bloodline of the Christ was perpetuated. They tried to hijack it, and so you've got all of the speculation about Jesus and Mary and all the rest of it. And it was speculation, because Mary actually did go to Lyon, France, and she had a boy with her that she did raise, but the boy belonged to Jesus and Martha. She was the younger sister of Mary, and she was the one that was dragged to be stoned before Jesus. And they did that because they knew that she was caught with him. They were husband and wife in secret. Mary herself could not conceive a child, and under the Essene tradition, if the wife could not conceive within 3 years, then because it's all about the royal bloodline, then the husband could take the younger sister, and that's what was done. It's all about genetics. So, you know, with the hate fest going on, Martha was ostracized. There were only four women at the cross, the three Marys and Martha at his feet. I was actually caressing them, and the blood, of course, was the Roman murderer, stuck the spear in, and the blood drained from his body. It went over Martha and then ran down at the same time that the earthquake was happening, and was kept safe, hidden, until 1982, when Ron Wyatt, a humble man, was directed by the angelic realm to find Jeremiah's grotto, the Ark of the Covenant. So it's all been kept hidden again. Israel, of course, tried to hijack it. The Jews call themselves Jews in a knot. Tried to hijack it. Then they sent in numerous, some say six others, Ron Wyatt himself says four, Israeli archaeologists and scientists went into Jeremiah's grotto. And when they didn't come out after some time, they actually got Ron White, who had already gone back to America, got him back to go in, because they knew that unless somebody was holy and pure, they could not approach the Ark of the Covenant. And so Ron White went in and brought out these four bodies of these scientists. They each had a stroke. Their eyes were crossed, indicating a stroke suddenly. So it's been sealed up again until this time now, when it's revealed that it was found almost years ago. And because, as you know, Sherrie, it's all about the mathematics, the synchronicity of the movement of the solar system as it's been travelling northward, 69,000 kilometres per hour, and that's how time is measured. So, you know, as Jesus, and it was the soul, it was the Father in that. That's what
it's called. Moon, blood, moon.
Yeah. And we get down to this time now. The resurrection, as you know, it occurred on the 6th of April, 33 AD, and of course that was his conception date, this time down in his second incarnation, the 6th of April, Australian time, because we're one day ahead of the rest of the world, and that was his conception. So you've done an amazing job. I love your forensic, you know, you're our yard cop, set you on it, and you... it's only the finer details that
it's all good.
You did a great job. So, the quarter moon that happened on the 6th of December last week, yeah, because I'm trying to get in as much as I can, because you know, as we get cut off. The quarter moon that happened last week was an absolute impossibility because it was a blood moon here over Australia, Tuggum. It was a clear night, there was no snow or anything. It was an absolutely clear night. And the position of the moon, if you look at it on the planetariums and things, it's beside the Earth. So it was directly in front of the sun, and a blood moon occurs because of the atmosphere. The moon, when it's in the shadow of the Earth, the atmosphere of the Earth removes, if you like, the blue spectrum, and then you've got the red spectrum shining on the full face of the moon. So, this occurred, much to everybody's surprise. Joel captured it, as you know, and of course, you know, everything being prophetic. We've got the book of Joel living here with us. He's the dude that does all of our uploading. And so he captured it. Nobody else has been talking about it, but it was 6:12. It was the sixth day of the 12th month at 1:05 a.m. 1:05 means eagle or angel, and of course it identifies again Yahweh's rebirth location, which was 1:05 Rothschild Avenue on his rebirth date of 11th of January 1944, which is the key to the House of David, all identified by the 50th layer of the pyramid. Which is all about him. That's his altar to himself. Now, the red was called, you know, yeah, I was looking at this, and you know, we wrapped Joel over the knuckles the next morning.
Where's this smoke coming from?
because he didn't come racing up the stairs and say, yeah, there's a blood moon. So, you know, we slept for it while Joel captured it, but it's all appropriate. What it means is that if you go to the Revelation 6:12, it talks about a great earthquake and then something else and then blood moon. Well, all of those things happen.
So yeah, that's all
fine.
From a system of a photograph of a red sphere bigger than the sun, which is what colours the moon to go red.
Yeah, okay. So Yah said the only way that this can happen is an atmosphere from another planet out there was again filtering out the moon effect from under the sun.
Or it's glowing red. Or it's
glowing red. Right. Now, Adam, our conversation with Adam last night, he's in Poland. And he happened to tell us that his sister-in-law took a photograph of the sunrise, and there was the red planet, huge. It was actually bigger than the sun, that rose with the sun, which would have meant it is now in front of the sun, that much closer to the Earth, and would account for the blood moon that nobody's talking about that occurred here. We saw it and captured on a film on the 6th of December, 6:12, the revelation.
Nobody thought fucking about it. It was there. Sorry.
Of course. So that's all very exciting in the house of God when these things happen to a world that rejects him. And we are days away from absolutely everything being all over. All prophecy has been fulfilled. It's all about the revelation. It's about the second coming of the Christ, the name he would have written, that only he would know, the new name from the Revelation 3:12 that Jesus told through Michael the archangel to John on the Isle of Patmos on the 96th day of the year, the 96th year AD, because
that accounts for all of the nuclear weapons, all of the atomic weapons that have been developed by Israel and they've put throughout the cities of the world. The other day the Americans tried to set off a nuclear weapon on the ground. It didn't work. And I've been saying no more nuclear weapons can work on the northern side of the Milky Way Galaxy.
It's like so
these fucking Jews, they can't set off these weapons, which they want to do because they're all demonized sons of Cain, John 8:44, and they're trying to kill everybody on earth.
Yep.
That's what they're trying to do. So it can't work no more. The Yanks have done it for us. They've tested it, the damn thing wouldn't go off.
Well, actually, John forwarded a clip like this where it just goes click. Hmm. And there's nothing.
Little cat.
It was like, yeah, it was just like, you know, pulling a trigger on a toy gun. And that's the
Oh my god, so amazing. Exactly, that's what they're doing, the north side. Does everybody know that we're on the north side?
Already?
Talking out?
So the Jews are very careful. The Jews have cleverly place these bombs in every city of the world, thinking they'll have the last go and detonate them all together. And because they can't do that no more, and it's also been exposed as what they plan to do, then of course they can't do it no more, but we do know what our souls are, and they're all going to go. Simple as that.
Yeah, that is, and no, that they're racing to try to do so much stuff.
Yeah.
They were in such a hurry. That's why they troll us. And that's why 24/7 debate don't fall, because they are losing. They need to troll because they were winning. Right?
Right.
They wouldn't even need to troll if they were winning.
Well, you see, they're not going to give up until they have no choice. And that is when they're out of here.
And not one of them is sorry. Not one of them is like, oops, I made a mistake. Like, for Alex Jones, for example, he had an opportunity to say, yes, I'm surrounded by CIA. Yes, I'm not in. He had an opportunity. His opportunity completed, and he didn't. To go and arrest them.
Well, they would have killed you if they could.
Yeah, that's right. They would have killed us if they could. That's what they want to do, and they would have done it. They all have all the food and water. They can't stick with the angels. So the angels are not right yet. Some people might not know that the angels actually are battling it all out for us. Is that right?
The angels are battling it all out for us.
They're all battling it out, yeah. That's right.
And we've not even gotten information that I got. I know it's angelic, it just comes to me.
Yeah. I mean, the mere fact that we're actually alive and got cells that are doing this miraculous things, 100 trillion cells working at the speed of light almost, keeping you alive, that itself is a testimony that it's a creation. So we've hooked into the universal consciousness, which is what creation is, and it's past, present, and future all at once. And you've got to have one bunny jump up in front of you in the headlights and you're going to run over it because the world has been bullshitted by the Jews.
Right.
So this bunny don't jump out of the way, or this little black duck.
Yeah.
Right.
That's good.
That's their problem. Sudden realization that they're rooted.
$7 billion waiting for the number.
Yeah.
Even Justin Bieber, it's Justin Bieber, I don't know who he is, but I was listening to there's 7 billion people in the world, like the elite, and we are consumed with 7 billion, they're consumed with seven, they're consumed with the fact that, like, they themselves talk about all this stuff.
Actually, what they are consumed about is forbidden Christ. They really don't give a stuff about the 7 billion. They've been consumed with Christ ever since the cross. And their protocols of Zion number 14, one small line, we shall forbid Christ. So everything, the changing of your YouTube, everything has been designed to forbid the knowledge that the Christ has been on the earth since his rebirth. Everybody reincarnates, going through the judgment, it's all happening now. And can you imagine, Sherrie, there are millions of people around, hundreds of millions of people. Think of all of the Catholics, and Brian was reborn into a Catholic family for a reason. He was not born into a welcoming priesthood at this time because we have been in hell. That's what the south side of the equatorial line is being about, hell. He was born into a family that themselves, although the genetics were consumed and devoured by the same enemy. And right, 1944, World War II, which of course was all brought about by the New World Order. And so he was born into the darkest hour. And Palestine has been the test case for all of the world leaders. As Israel has been allowed by the world leaders. Everybody else has been made pretty much powerless, as you know, in their world. They've been making all the decisions. However, it has been a testing ground for God, who is back here, judging what to do. Here is
Shema. You know
where
I heard that?
The more we use the internet, the more our current copper network is struggling to keep up. After all, it was originally designed for copper, not today's internet. The National Broadband Network is a network that can deliver our needs now and into the future.
It's funny, I've got everything else muted, but the ads come in, it won't be muted.
Yeah.
Anyway, look, Yahweh was just explaining that Hiroshima was all about trying to start a chain reaction then, but they were being prevented. And it really has been the judging of the nations, the leaders of the world, as they have allowed one atrocity to go on, and particularly the Christian Western nations who believe and, you know, this. Just ask how many Christians there are going to their churches, paying their preachers to hear bullshit, and are supporting Israel because they believe that God has chosen these dogs that are in Israel. These are the Jews who call themselves Jews and are not, that were condemned before, as Jesus, he went to the cross, all through the Revelation. They are the synagogue of Satan. They have occupied Israel, which is Palestine. It was Palestine at the cross. Palestine was the land of the holy people. Everything was to do with the people at that time, including the Revelation, which was the condemnation of 6 out of the 7 churches that had already been established throughout Turkey, the churches of Turkey. And just look at Turkey today, how it is joining with the beast and allowing NATO to set up, and on the pretext of Syria. My God, these names, Palestine and Syria and Iran, these are godly people. As you know, Almighty, who Jesus Christ is, he doesn't give a stuff what they call him. It's all about what do you do, what did Jesus do, not a debate about what it was that people think he said that was written down 200 years after the fact. It was all about living the way he lived, which was truth and compassion and fearless judgment of the enemy, overturning the money changers in the temple. Well, the temple was a microcosm of the world today. So you've got the same money changers who are the Pharisee Jews from Babylon in the priests at that time. They also have reincarnated, and they have been running and controlling the temple today, the head dude being the House of Rothschild, then the Queen of England, of course, the British royal family related to Vlad the Impaler, and all of the puppet minions around the globe. So, and then the millions and millions and millions of people out of America in their churches, supposed to be Jesus loving. Well, I'll tell you what, they are worshipping the image of the beast. The image of the beast is that image that the beast has built up in all of the West's mind, the namby-pamby, airy-fairy bullshit Jesus that would sit back and watch babies be slaughtered, the Palestinian children be blown to pieces by the dogs out of Israel who have been yapping and howling, and America is there and able. So you think that judgment is going to be, you know, you've got another thing coming. It's all happening now. Everybody is being judged, and it ain't happening. We are running out of time, and the only name that has salvation today is the name of the Lord, the new name, the name written that only he would know, that only he can reveal to a dumbed down deceived world, and that name is Brian Leonard Golightly Marshall. So I suggest in the days ahead that everybody, as shit hits the fan more than it has been, call on that name. You may have a hope. Outside of that, many, many people have been having dreams and visions all around the world. As you know, Adam is the point person for it all. He has chosen to be crucified this time, and the angelic realm is giving him the skinny. And when we say locked and loaded, that came from Catherine. That was directly from her angel Ariel. Everything, it is locked and loaded. What does that mean? That's one command past the commander-in-chief, who's actually commanding the troops. It's the troops responding. The next order they are looking for is take aim and then fire. That's how close to midnight it is for the world. So the name has to get out there. I don't care who's listening to this and who's objecting. If you reject, you reject. That's it, you're out here. It's all about the judgment. You've been bullshitted. Wake up. This thing about Alex Jones has been going on for more than a decade. Yahweh told the world right from the beginning he was working for the opposition. That's years ago now. He was sent all of the information. Brian said it to him years ago, as soon as he was able to get on the net. William Cooper was telling the truth, so he gets slaughtered. Shortly after, to make way for the prince of the power of the air is Alex Jones, the devil himself. So yeah. Now, Jupiter belongs to God. It is the planet that belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ. Why? The Alpha and the Omega. What does it mean? It means it was a great big clue to the world. I'll use the Greek gematria alphabet. 888 is Jesus in the Greek gematria. Jupiter is 88,800 miles wide. 888, it is his planet. So there you have Prince of the Power of the Air in Alex Jones saying, I'm Jupiter. No, he ain't. He's just a slime bag and he's out of here. He was given every opportunity. He's had all of the information for years now. Sherrie's been on his case. He's had the information and he has refused to tell the world the only thing that will save him. So you think he's a patriot? No. He is one of them. He's of the synagogue of Satan.
Yes, yes, and he even did the thing. That's what they do it. They have to, like, when back in the day when I was in music, we didn't know any better. We'd be like, rock and roll, but we didn't know. Like, I honestly didn't know that was a satanic thing. I just thought it was like rebel, you know? And you know, when I start seeing the politicians did that, God, this is not, I can't do it anymore.
Everything. The revelation is about exposing everything. And only that Christ can do it. The altar to the Lord in the midst of Egypt is the great pyramid that was built by the descendants of Noah. It was not built by the Egyptians. They were stupid, as you know, because the elite of the world, you know, they were in Egypt. And the Shemites, the shepherd kings, the descendants of Noah came from Palestine. That's why Palestine, the Jews who call themselves Jews, have been trying to annihilate it. The people of Palestine are the holy people. That is in a nutshell. And anybody who has supported Israel, whether they be Christian, whatever you call yourself, you have been judged. If anybody thinks, now the God of the Torah is Lucifer. Jesus came and he was preaching love, peace, judgment. At that time it was about forgiveness, but it's about judgment this time because the world's a whole lot worse this time in the second incarnation because of the same evil priests. The Jews have called themselves Jews and not disguise themselves as the elite. It's not the Illuminati. Jew world order, Jew world domination has been the plan from the beginning. So, you know, there you've got Jones leading the sheep up a very broad road, a path to destruction. The way is narrow. Jesus said the way is narrow. Why? He was an Essene. Essenes were the healers. They were peacemakers until he showed up on the scene. And then the Essenes themselves turned against Jesus. They were all part of the crucifixion because he came preaching a truth that even they did not want to hear. So, America, what small part might be listening, it's all to fulfill the rejection prophecy as well. So everybody's done a really good job. You've all rejected God Almighty. So man without God is what you've got. And it is not going to continue. In the very near future, when this is all done and dusted, the King of Kings rules with a rod of iron because man cannot do it. He either becomes an atheist who thinks that, you know, the science has just been so dumbed down. It's
yeah.
It's all been sorted now. I'm on a roll because we got on the air. The days are short. We are counting down. It is locked and loaded. And that's the only day that we say, Brian, let it go, Lightning Marshall. Doesn't matter whether you believe it or not. Now, there are
I have this miracle myself. Everyone around me has seen it. If so-called these other freaks were right, then I would have been smited down. I use Brian and Yahweh and you guys as my, basically my yardstick. Everything I say in your honor, and I've witnessed miracles. And look at all the codes I've cracked. Look, it's Molly for anything. I mean, that all comes to the great name of Yahweh, Brian, God. All of it. I've been destroyed.
Now, to explain, we've been in a timeline, if you like. The victory was won at the cross. That it was all done and dusted there in the spiritual realm, which is really a dream. It's all been a dream of the Creator. And what was the Creator? A baby within the womb of the cosmos. How the hell am I going to get myself out of here? Everything began with thought. So we have been living a dream that has been hijacked by the evil in men. Man creates evil. God did not create it. Man chooses. This is where free will has got us. Man has chosen to do evil, and because they are God in the flesh, they have created the spiritual realm known as the demonic and evil. And these things manifest because God is the creator. So all of this has to be consumed at this time now, because Yahweh is sick and tired of it. He's an old man this time, as the Ancient of Days, and he is running out of patience with everything. And we, for the sake of the children and the meek who inherit, then we move forward in time. It's all been done and dusted. Everything has been judged. So, it's all about the world repenting. That was the other message from the angel. Flocked and loaded, all must repent. And the only name that saves today is Ryan, let it go, Lightly Marshall. One day rejected and crucified for now. 68.95 years. You'll be 69, which means Jehovah, Yahweh, on his 69th birthday, 11th of January 2013. Is that good? So, 68, of course, all years, the stone, he is the capstone to the pyramid, and of course he is rejected. So, that's why the enemy has hijacked the pyramid. They know nothing about it, they use it for evil means, and they are counterfeit in the copycat, because the creation is a design. It's all to do with mathematics, the measuring, and as the grand architect that is God Almighty himself, right? Let me go, Lightly Marshall.
Jesus,
that's
a
good question. I've got to talk about that.
I've got to go. When they're little, and make sure nobody can find this out. Because once you go through it, it's already obvious that it's just like stupid.
Well, of course, years ago, hundreds of years ago, you had to be able to speak Greek to get into the English universities, and you had to know the geometry and the measure of the earth, because that's how God lays things out. As any architect does, and anybody who's building a building, in those days, it was the measure of a man. So the name of the king, or the measure of himself, meaning his body weight and his height, was in the dimensions of whatever it was that he was building for himself. So you would expect God to have the measure of himself within the measuring of the creation. Now, the Revelation 3:12 talks about the new name, the new name, and of course that's Ryan, let it go, Lightly Marshall, which has an English gematria of 312. Also, when added, the entire verse adds up to 2520. In English gematria, when you multiply that by 10, it's the age Yahweh will be on his 69th birthday, and it is in the Gregorian calendar, 69 years, or in the Hebrew calendar of just 360 days, it will be 70 years, and the whole 70 years is the missing week of Daniel's prophecy. All academia have missed it. They are focusing on looking for one week period of 70 years. Well, this time, because it's all about numbers and the numbers are interchangeable, the 69 weeks of 7 years were finished at the cross, but the 70th week, the one that is missing, is his entire lifetime of 69 Gregorian years or 70 Hebrew years. This time, that is the rejection of God Almighty.
Yeah, not even know this map. It's just everywhere. 69, they got the fish thing, and 69. I mean, obviously these numbers mean so much to the enemy.
Of course. Now, what the King James Version of the Bible, 1611 only, what is holy about it are the numbers of the chapters and verses, because the men who did it were divinely guided. The words themselves have been manipulated. There has been a great deal of omission. And it's a Freemason construct, the 1611. However, because God is way smarter than men and knew what men would do, 1830s, you've got 100 academics led by James Strong, who published the 1830 edition of the James Strong Concordance, listing all 8,674 words of the King James 1611 in the Hebrew Old Testament, then the 5,624 words of the Greek New Testament. It's all to do with the numbers. So when the Christ comes back to the earth, identified by his altar to himself, which is the Great Pyramid, and then begins revealing it to a dumped-down world, because he realizes, oh my God, this is hell. I've been born into the pit of hell. And so he has to work it out for everybody so that everybody can follow him out of hell. Right now, everybody's choosing to remain in their rabbit holes. you've got all the Christian rabbit holes, you've got all the other aliens, UFOs. It doesn't matter. They are all rabbit holes to distract from the knowledge that the Christ is here and he's leading
Abel's
the way
blood
out.
And cries out from the
and all of the blood, Abel's blood. Abel was the first that was murdered by his brother Cain. Cain is the father of all of these wicked that are back, Jews that call themselves Jews that are not. That's why as Jesus he condemned them. John 8:44, ye are of your father the devil, who was a liar and a murderer from the beginning. They are the sons and the seed of Cain, and Abel's blood is in the earth and it is crying out for judgment. That's what it's on. Not only that, you've got the blood that was shed at the cross in the earth that still remains over the Ark of the Covenant that has sealed it shut. None of that matters anymore. The Christ is already here. He takes over. It's an overturning, not an election. Nobody's going to be voting. He will appoint the rulers of the nation and they will all go to him for counsel as he rules with a rod on, because self-free will has got us to this point now. So if you don't like it, tough. The way it's the script, we're nearing the end of the script, and it's not an election. So, I'm going to put the microphone up to you because I need a drink of water. Here it is. I need a drink of water.
It's not a question.
You have to go and get some water because the pool is
going
to go around.
Oh, it's so hot.
There it is, we got one for you.
Okay, it's small.
Yeah, so it's all over, right? And that's it.
Yeah, it's all over. Right. Really is the thing playing out. You can see it. I was lucky I didn't get any religion when I was growing up. It wasn't talked about, it wasn't knocked. It was just basically, we assumed there was a God, and I assumed that identification was Jesus. So I never had an indoctrination. It was just like an open spot. I could take everything and weigh it out. That sounds right, that doesn't feel right. But the only thing that makes sense is what they knew. That's the only thing that makes sense. I studied it at all.
So,
the only thing that makes sense is doctrine, right, life, incarnation, karma. The whole thing be played out, the way time stopped. Like, I'm just a person, I didn't even finish the school action, and it's just that obvious. And anybody that doesn't want to see it, it's just they refusing to not see it.
Right.
It's all about being humble, Molly. Humility and spirit.
Yeah. And to even not think, like, the people that are so stubborn and are trolls and everything, well, most of the trolls are demonic, but the people that don't say, wow, that's interesting, they'd like to know more than that. Maybe that works. Maybe that doesn't. They should at least have some sort of, like, you know, to go. Maybe that could be. But they're like, oh, 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 you know, government.
Yeah, and what the West needs to really bring coming too late, because we're in the judgment, is that this period of time since the rebirth of the Christ, when the Star of Bethlehem occurred for a second time, 11th of January 1944 over Sydney, Australia, then this period of time has been called the Resurrection. Now, Sherrie, you won't understand this because you have no biblical knowledge, but there are those out there who know what I mean. So the resurrection has been this period of time, and the scriptures say that you are resurrected either to life or to death. So it's already, if you
look, oh, yeah.
Yahweh puts it this way, the judgment has already occurred in the heavenly realm. Now it is the sentencing to be carried out. All souls have been reborn and gathered back on the earth for the sentencing to be carried out. And they have been born again through the womb of a mother, just as that's how God gets to the earth, because, you know, he's always said, what does a God go and look in through the window at the maternity ward? Then, so everybody's gathered back for the judgment. It's already a done deal. That's why he, as the Lamb, is the one that opens the scrolls and the books, and he opened the scroll while he was in Canada, actually. So that's what's happening. Everybody's had lots of opportunities.
We're spiritually dead. It's the resurrection of that, like that, right?
Well, no, we're talking about a bodily resurrection, just as Jesus, he bodily resurrected, his body was made alive, yeah. His flesh body was made alive again, that time through the power of the nuclear fission, if you like, of the resurrection. And then, everything he fulfilled as Jesus was prophetic and foretelling of what must be accomplished in his second incarnation, when he prophesied then that he would be rejected. If you go over to Luke 17, it talks about how the Son of Man must suffer many things by this generation. At that time, he was speaking about that generation of the future, meaning this generation now, which is the most evil generation because it has allowed what has gone on to go on. And it also talks about how the men of Nineveh, who repented at the word of Jonas, that they would rise up in this generation now, so they're on the earth, and they are aghast, and they condemn this generation for how evil they are. What has been going on is an absolute abomination, and what has made the abomination that makes desolate is Judaism, the Talmudic Judaism that people associate with Christianity, Judeo-Christian. The West has fallen for it. They've been preaching a kind of Judaism from their pulpits. No preacher has got it right. All 36,000 denominations, a house divided against itself, cannot stand. They have been preaching of the synagogue of Satan, and that's how it was all orchestrated. That was after the War of Independence, 1776. There was a conversation between Cornwallis and Washington, and Cornwallis told him, well, you know, it may seem like you've won the war, however, in 200 years' time, you will be preaching Judaism from your pulpits, and America, who will think it's not free, will be the biggest prison of all. And, you know, everybody in America is living at the prison planet, and yes, Alex Jones is the gatekeeper. However, that is not the big news. What he hasn't told Americans who proclaim to be a Christian nation is that the Christ is already here. And everybody has to be given the opportunity, whether they believe it or not, doesn't matter. They have to be given the opportunity to have the information and to make up their own minds. And because he is rejected, that's what they do. The whole world rejects, except for the very few like yourself. And I had to find him first and then announce it to the world because I'm that angel that goes, hello, blows a trumpet. That's me saying, hello, world, this is, you know, the Lord is here. So all of these things, it's all coming to pass now. It's all good for the good, it's not so for those who are being judged. It's not going to be pretty at all, not at all. So, that's where we're at. That's the only name that's going to say. Brian, Leonard, Golightly, Marshall.
So every time someone buys something in America, the sales tax goes to buy a weapon to blow up someone in Palestine.
There you go. Because the sales tax goes to buy a weapon to kill somebody in Palestine.
I've never paid tax to Australia at all.
Okay. Yeah, I was also a Canadian citizen. He was there for years, all part of the DVD. Canada is just as bad. Stephen Harper, who calls himself a Christian, is another Zionist, and he is
called. Oh, Stephen Harper, he's a And he looks like Clinton, and they're all in brown.
Yes, they are. Yeah. So, and you're right, you know, you've been harping on and on and on about the bloodlines and all that, that's what it's all about. So there is a genetic bloodline from Jesus and Martha who's alive on the earth today. It was kept safe and hidden. Nobody talks about it. Martha's been written out of the record because, in fact, she is like the Counter-Strike, hidden until this time because she was the mouth of herself then and is the mouth of herself now because she's so short, 5 feet nothing.
I wanted to ask you guys what you thought of Kate and Roland being pregnant and Queen building for them to have a baby in her stomach so she could try to squeeze in.
They're not going to be around. Now, what is interesting is that the nurse who passed through that prank call from two Australian DJs, two idiots, making a prank call, and the nurse ends up dead. That passed the call through, they say it was suicide, she was a mother of two, and her body was found not at home where you'd expect somebody committing suicide to, you know, in the garage while she's home alone or anything, but it's actually in the street, a short distance from the hospital. So how did she die? Everybody's blaming, you know, now the two DJs, but if you remember their tour that they had recently, the dead bodies that turned up in France, that correlated with the dead bodies from years ago when the Queen Mother was there. Elizabeth, it's all part of their ritual, as you know. So nobody's asking questions of how come there's another dead body turning up where Kate and William are. Now, of course, they had to have somebody like Kate, who is clueless, because Diana, of course, gave them such a hard time. She was the human factor in their life, and she was God's kid. So they made sure he married somebody who was totally clueless. The baby in her womb, well, you know, it's it ain't from God. Elizabeth sits on the throne of David. The United Kingdom is all to do with James the First of England, the Sixth of Scotland, the descendant of William the First, Yahweh's ancestor, whose birth and death date was on December 4th, born 1143, died 1215. He is the genetic bloodline, and he had a son by his second wife, Henry Golightly, who had a son called Patrick Golightly. And then, of course, the Marshalls were all part of his family too. The daughters married Marshalls, who came over from Normandy with William the Conqueror. So that's what it's all about. It's bloodline right back. Not Solomon. Solomon was evil. He was the bastard son of Bathsheba. She was the adulteress. She tricked David on his deathbed. The rightful king was from his fourth wife, Haggith, who was his favourite. She had a son called Adoniah, which means worshipper of Yah. He was to be the rightful king. The treachery of Bathsheba and her lies and deceit, and then Solomon himself, who killed Adoniah the day that David died. He'd already been made king. So it's all through treachery, murder, deception. And this is what the queen in her counterfeit royal bloodline says that she's descended from. Well, of course, the revelation identifies Solomon as the beginning of the Antichrist. 666 talents were paid by each one of his Moabite, Ammonite wives, 700 wives and 300 concubines. And he was evil, absolutely evil. He started out okay, but then he fell to evil, and he actually, you know, it seems like he repented on his deathbed, and he wrote a testament explaining what went on and how come he had authority over the demonic world that he used to build the Temple of Solomon. That's why it was destroyed. The temple will be rebuilt this time by the Persians. The Persians have always done what God has asked them to do, even though they might not know his name. Sirius, Darius, they were all God's people at the time. Of course, you have Ahmadinejad at the moment, lovely, lovely man, who is a man of peace, love. He is, in fact, Yahweh has proven it, the reincarnated bloodline of the prophet Muhammad. He doesn't wear a necktie. Anybody wearing a necktie, they're connected to all the bullshit, the Freemasonry, and it's all about hands on neck, Freemasonry. It's all part of their, as I think of. So, you look for the men who are not wearing ties?
Yeah, that's funny. I know somebody else says that too, though. If I know, I'd never trust someone with a necktie.
Totally. Yeah. So that's the short and skinny of it.
And now, if you want to ask this people that you're talking to, we can demonstrate one miracle worldwide.
And are you going to do that now?
We can do it in 2 minutes. And people at home can go and prove it.
So, we should do it weekly or whenever you
guys
feel
like
it.
Hey, do it
now if you like.
Because this is being recorded. So.
Yeah, I think she's saying, do you want to do a weekly broadcast?
Absolutely.
People to send me the questions on that other channel, the one that I'm locked out, Ms. Sherrie Lee. Ms. Sherrie Lee channel, send in any questions for Ryan and Janelle. I'm recording this, so I'm going to post it there. My only problem is that when I go to put it on my Sherrie Lee channel, I have to put it in through my email, and then the email says I have a 20 MB max, so I'll have to put it in little parts because it's complicated now that I'm locked out of that channel. Just my channel was getting good, I got locked out. As you all know, because you're all from
Right. Anyhow, that's the challenge. Anyone in the world who runs a radio station or TV station, I will give the instructions of what the people should do, and they could then go prove within 2 minutes something that is an impossibility, but they can see it with their own eyes, and therefore they can then announce my name.
Exactly.
Pretty tight challenge there. I'll prove it right before they're right.
I just said to Donnie tonight, I saw his name on my Facebook, and I said, Donnie, prove that you're not part of them, because now everybody says that Freedom Prize Radio and all of those are part, and you know what, Donnie admitted to being a Jew, and he owns the fake Jew, that's why he's the Star of David and all that stuff. Anybody that's part of Freedom Prize Radio or Alternative Radio, they're all part of it.
All of them. Tell her that he got one on Sunday.
We don't know it.
Yeah.
What, did Johnny send that message?
Yeah, well, that's what he said yesterday.
Oh, Sunday, was it? Oh, okay.
So we're going on air with Johnny Gilson on Sunday.
Oh, did you? So then he's... No,
we're going to.
No,
we're going to.
Next Sunday.
Oh, next Sunday, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Brian and Johnny Gilson, that's good. That makes me happy because I thought he was shutting everything up. Brian will... I'm going to promote that, Donnie Gilson. So next Sunday, that means a week today.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Awesome. Amazing. I'm going to promote that. That's exciting. I can't wait to promote that.
Well, just make sure we get that challenge in there.
Yeah, the challenge. Any company? Well, are you saying that the challenge is that they...
The challenge is anybody who follows my instructions that I give them in 2 minutes can prove that I am Yahweh.
Yeah.
And if I don't, I'll go back where I come from.
And men's will. Exactly. So, got some tapes. Come on. I got a lot of trolls. Why not? Let's see. And you know what? I've noticed these trolls, they just back off. They don't say anything. They just back down. It's just here. And that's what happens to you guys, too. The trolls, they just disappear, right? Stay a second and then they're gone.
I love the trolls.
Of the trolls, because the trolls do more, they actually have more press than they go against the class on the block.
Well, the whole point is that they go on yapping on, proving me wrong, and of course they always make a balls up of it. So, just let them keep rolling because they are getting that name out there.
They but are.
It's all over. It's all over. Israel's finished.
And I hear you guys are eating. Is it daytime there? It's like your breakfast.
Yeah, it's dinner time. Karen's just cutting up our potatoes for us.
I okay. That's awesome. I'm going to stop recording because the sooner I stop recording, the smaller the files will be and then I can upload it.
Right.
Okay. All right. All right, love you guys.
Hasta la vista, baby.
It's recording it too, right? Or
he's recording.
On about four different cameras.
Awesome. Bye.
Love you.
I'm just kissed. Love you. Bye.
See ya.
Bye. Okay, I'll sign up and I'll hit stop record. And to anybody that's been listening, come on back. We're just going to keep doing this and love it. Bye.
Okay,
that's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
That's a wrap.